Would you like to create a nature scene in Blender that looks as realistic as this one? If you want to learn how to create a landscape in Blender and do professional color grading in DaVinci Resolve, let's take a look at each stage in this video tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and let's go to make something amazing! I'm starting with the landscape add-on in Blender, which is free add-on. It comes with many presets, but I'm especially looking for lake presets. This preset is great because it includes both terrain and water surface. That's what I need. After adding the lake preset, I'm going to use the botanic add-on to create a grass field. But before we proceed, it's important to paint the area with vertex group where you want to see this grass. I wouldn't want to see grass growing in the water, so I painted the area around the lake. Then I select a suitable grass preset and I need to select the vertex group that I painted before for density and length parameter. It creates a field that looks very realistic. In this cutter we also have a setting that I want to change, like scale and randomized rotation. It brings more natural look in this grass field. Also, I have control of this grass using the vertex group. Okay, I need a hero object for my project and I found this amazing house on SketchUp. I used their add-on to import it in my Blender scene and now I do copy and paste it somewhere here in my main scene. If you need help placing object according to the composition, you can use camera guidelines to see composition better. I would like to have some trees like on my render. Again, I'm going to use the botanic add-on and it would be great to have this particular tree and place them behind the house. Additionally, I do copy and scale this tree to put it somewhere around here. Also, it would be nice to see some trees growing through the holes in the house. Great, let's add the forest in the background. I add a new plane, scale it, and I'm going to extrude a face to create surface for the ground of this forest. Then I need to subdivide geometry to create a vertex group to scatter the trees. Again, go to weight paint mode and let's paint mask where I want this forest growing. It may be some rough mask because it's a background forest. Okay, now I use the botanic add-on once more and I need a new scatter, but without objects because I scroll down and here I can choose a specific tree for the scatter. I select the same tree, it doesn't matter for me now. But it's so huge density. I decrease it and I start with 100. Of course I need to choose the vertex group that I painted before for density. And okay, maybe decrease the scale and make more variety using randomization settings. Also using weight paint, I can adjust the density for this forest. And let's duplicate this forest once to place it even further to create more depth in the render. Finally, for this landscape creation, I add another trees to balance the composition. Now it looks good, maybe we will move some object on the next stage, we'll see. So, turn on the preview render and let's add some light. I'm going to use the sky texture available in the Blender and make some changes to get nice sunlight. It looks nice, but the sky is boring. Let's replace with something more attractive. I add a new plane for this, change the size to something like this and add a new material. I have this amazing sky image and just drop this image into the shader editor and connect to principal VSDF. We may see if it's look correct in the viewport. So rotate this plane by x-axis and I have to place this sky behind the blender scene. Adjust the size that cover all camera views even more because I want to render an animation with camera movement and I need some margin around the camera border for the sky. I guess I'll leave this sky for some kind of like this for now. Of course, we need to use this image as an emission, just connected to material and set value 1. I guess it's enough. If we use a plane for the sky with another light source like sky texture, we must deselect shadows in the object properties for this plane. It's necessary only for the sky, as we don't need to cast shadow from this object. Let's focus on the materials. I add a new material to the water surface and I have interesting water surface texture from Megascans. Maybe this one. I copy the path to these textures, go in a blender and press Shift Ctrl F, paste here path and select all necessary textures. Blender automatically connects them into the right socket. We just need to make unwrap to this plane. Alright, I scale the texture a little bit, maybe like this one. Now I wanna change the material for the ground. Maybe this one would be pretty well. I delete the material from the Botanic add-on, add new principal BSDF and then textures. Of course, we need to unwrap the surface. Scale mapping to natural size. For more natural effect, I'm going to use a displacement and I go to the material settings and in the displacement change bump only to displacement and bump. We need to subdivide this plane with the subdivision surface modifier. Not much, maybe 2 times enough. And also we need to decrease the scale of the displacement in the material. Around 0.1 or 0.2 would be enough. So yeah, looks correct, I think. So let's walk with this house. I guess it's so clean for this situation. I mean, these materials look so clean. I think it should be looking more dirtier and older. I have old wood texture, let's try maybe this one, like a basic wood material. I delete all this texture and new principal BSDF and textures and what does it look like? Yeah, pretty good, maybe change the scale. Nice, but it's still so clean. I add a hue saturation to decrease the value to make it darker and maybe decrease saturation. Next I want to add ambient occlusion and color ramp to control this ambient occlusion. Mix not and I'm going to use this ambient occlusion as a factor or maybe second color in mix not. It will add darker part to geometry, we will see what will work better. Using the color ramp, I'm going to select some range in the geometry corners, like the dirt effect. So, experimenting with blending mode and mix color. And still pretty clean. I think we add some dirt map to this material. Maybe this one. Add mix color and connect this dirt map. Scale it and change the blending mode to multiply or maybe overlay. Yeah, overlay looks better. I think we missed the roughness map from this wood. I don't see roughness. Here, let's connect it to our wood material, and I think I also set color ramp. It's necessary to make this map more contrasting. But it's a lot of shiny now. So yeah, now I'm delighted with this wood material. Let's quickly fill the scene with other objects. And I briefly tell you that I use Megascans here and BlenderKit add-on, which has a very large library of models, materials, HDRIs and much more, both free and paid subscription. Follow the link in the description to download BlenderKit for free and use more than 20,000 free models and materials in your project. Also, if you want to dive deeper into how to create cinematic scene and make animation video in Blender, I have a masterclass for you where you can learn everything in details, from finding an idea and sketch to the final color grading so that your cinematic animation looks like a shoot from the movie. All the links are in the description, follow the link and get access to my masterclass today. But we continue and let's move to the camera animation. I'm going to use follow path to animate camera movement and I need to add this path. Place it here at the same height as the camera and I adjust this path some kind of like this. Now I need to reset the position of the camera. I select the camera and set location 0 for all axes. Now add object constraint, follow path and select my path. The camera moved to the position of this path. So I select follow curve and animate path. Now we may see that the camera is moving along this path if I play an animation, but not in the right direction. I want that camera focusing somewhere here. I can add some empty object to use this empty for target of the camera and place them somewhere here. Again, select the camera and add new object constraint, track 2, and pick this empty object. Now my camera will be moving along the path and always be targeted on this empty object. I can adjust the path and camera to stay focused in the right direction. And I can even move this empty and camera will move follow this empty. So now the camera moves fast and I want to create slower animation. Let's change the follow curve to fix its position. It allows me to use the offset factor to control moving the camera along this path. I place playhead in the first frame and set keyframe for offset. Go to the last frame and let's change offset a little bit and set a new key. Now if I play an animation, camera will move slower. Yeah, but too slow. Again, go to the last frame and change offset factor. Don't forget to set a new keyframe. Yeah, I guess that's what I need. The last important thing that I want to do before render the final animation is add motion blur. Since the camera moves along the scene, the object's foreground should be slightly blurred. I will enable motion blur in the render settings. Since the camera is moving slowly, I want to set it somewhere around 0.2. This will be enough and brings more realism. Finally, I want to add some mist to the artwork in Blender. Instead of volume fog and mist pass, I will use depth pass, which can be enabled for the render in render layers and I need to select the range of the depths which I can use by using map range. I want to add mist on the background, so I select the range from this house to a far distance and I add a mix color node to use this depth as a factor and second color of this mix node as a mist color. Now I can use this color to find interesting colors for mist. I have a video where I show the details how you can use compositing to add fog in Blender and why this method is more suitable than volume fog. So I recommend watching this video for more details, link on your screen. Alright, I like it and I think we can add file output and make settings for saving animation. I already explained in my video on the channel that we save the animation only as an image sequence and never use the video format for this. Link to this video also in the description, so you may also watch them for information. I'm going to use PNG format and 16-bit image because I need as much color range as possible to make color grading. So this is my final animation. It looks good, but I want to make some interesting color grading, and as you may see, I'm in DaVinci Resolve. If you are not familiar with DaVinci Resolve, DaVinci Resolve is professional video editing software. Originally known for its advanced color grading capabilities, Resolve has evolved into comprehensive post-production tools offering editing, color grading, visual effects and motion graphics. But for us, it's mostly interesting for color grading and post-production. Okay, I add a new timeline and drop my render sequence here. Now we can go to the color folder. All color grading will be done here. Briefly, DaVinci Resolve has a node structure as a blender. By adding nodes, we may make some adjustments in this node. So, I add a new node and here I make global contrast adjustments using lift, gamma, gain, contrast and shadows. It's the same as we remember from Blender, but DaVinci Resolve is a powerful tool that allows you to dive deeper into color grading. Before and after. The second node I'm going to use for color. Using Gamma, I can change the color of the full image, finding good looking color tone. And I have to mention, look at how DaVinci works faster. Those who have followed me for a long time may remember that I said that Blender Compositing has a huge disadvantage in speed, but look at how DaVinci works much faster. I change the color and everything updates immediately, despite of I work with 4K footage. I add another node for deep color correction. Using curves, I can even change the color from yellow to red or green. So I want to slightly change this yellow closer to the warm color, maybe slightly change green. Also using curves, I can impact separately to saturation, hue and brightness of selected colors. Next, I need a new node for working with mask. I want to use one of them here and make this part of the sky a little bit darker and add saturation. The second mask I want to use for the bottom part again make this part darker and decrease the saturation. In general, DaVinci is pretty flexible tool and allows you to work with the material at a deep level. That's why I saved the animation in PNG 16-bit to have more space doing post-production in DaVinci Resolve. Finally, I want to add effects like glow and film grain. The first one adds glow to the image, but reduce it a little bit because it's too much. And the second one adds film grain as the final effect. These effects work in the paid version. So if you have free DaVinci Resolve, then you will not have this effect, but everything else works in the free version as well. This is the final animation. If you have some question, feel free to ask it in the comment below. Subscribe, share this video with your friends, and I'll see you in the next episode.